Hello everyone. So today we are going to see exception propagation in PL SQL. So what is it? Exception block handles the exception which was raised in body or execution block, but cannot handle the exception which will raise in declaration block. So let us see example. If I copy this example and go to SQL plus prompt, let me clear this, and here we can see. So this is declaration block, but what is happening here? This is variable x and we are taking the size as 3, but here we are assigning the string with the 4 character. So in that case we will get error because the size of x is 3 and we are passing the character 4. So and here begin, we are printing x and here we are writing exception block. So let me execute this and here we go, we are getting the error. This exception block is not handling the whatever error in a declaration area. In the declaration area, whatever error is occurring, that is not handling by the exception block. But if we go and see second example, let me copy this. It is also same, but what is happening? That string we are assigning in the declaration, but here we are assigning in the execution block. From begin execution block is started and we are assigning value in execution block, and if I execute this and here we go, this is handling the exception. So exception block is handling the exception, only exception that will occur in the execution block, not in a declaration block. So here whenever we are assigning the value, it is handling the exception and we are getting the message invalid string length. But in the first case, here in the declaration block we are getting error, but the exception block is not handling this exception, so we are getting the error. So to overcome the above problem, we need to prepare nested PL SQL block. So to handle the exception in declaration block, we need to use nested PL SQL block. So what is exception propagation? To handle exception which was raised in declaration block, this is called as exception propagation. Exception propagation nothing but to handle the exception which was raised in declaration block. And how can we handle that? By using the nested PL SQL block. So now let us see solution for the above problem. Let me copy this, copy it, go to SQL Plus, clear the screen, paste here, and let us see. This is a what? Outer block from here to here, and this is inner block. So this exception will occur here and we will handle this exception in the outer block, and this statement will be executed. String length is greater than the size of the variable x and end of the program. So now let me execute this and here we go. We are handling the exception which was occur in the declaration block. So this is nothing but exception propagation. We are getting the message called string length is greater than size of the variable ax. So from this example we can conclude that in PL SQL exception are occurred in execution block and also in declaration block. So whenever exception are occurred in execution block, those exceptions are handled in the inner block. Whenever an exception are occurred in execution block, those exceptions are handled in inner block. But whereas when exception are occurred in declaration block, those exceptions are handled in the outer block only. This mechanism is called as exception propagation. So in the case we have seen that the exception occur in the declaration block, we are handling by using the exception block of the outer block. This mechanism is called as exception propagation. I will repeat this line. Whereas when exception are occurred in declaration block, those exception are handled in the outer block only. This mechanism is called exception propagation. So this is about exception propagation.